To start scanning a vessel on the Incucyte, click Schedule to acquire. This will open up the acquisition window where the current vessels scheduled to be scanned are displayed, along with a timeline showing when these scans will occur. To set up a new vessel, click on the blue plus icon on the left side of the screen that says Launch Add Vessel. At various points in the Incucyte software, pop-ups will appear giving the user additional information about different elements within the graphical user interface. This will open up the guided interface containing 11 steps, where the user can check the progression at the bottom of the screen. Initially, there are two options available to set up a scan. Scan on schedule, which creates a user-defined repeating schedule, or scan once now, which immediately initiates a single one-off scan. Double-click on the scan type or click Next to proceed to the Create or Restore Vessel page. Now the user has the choice to create a new vessel to scan, copy a current vessel that's currently scheduled, or copy the settings of a previously scanned vessel. There is also the option to restore a previously scanned vessel for additional scanning. The new scans are then added to the existing images in one experimental file. For now, we're going to choose Create New Vessel. In the Scan Type page, the relevant scanning mode, depending on the assay and application, is chosen. Different scanning modes may lead to pre-selection of objectives and tissue culture plastic specific to that scanning mode. The scan type standards, image lock, whole well, and dilution cloning are always available and functional. The scratch wound, chemotaxis, and spheroid scan types are enabled upon purchase of the applicable software module. Most assays, such as proliferation, cell death, phagocytosis, and 2D immune cell killing, are run using the standard scan type. Standard scanning also allows the selection of the cell-by-cell scanning options should the module be enabled. In the scan settings page, the desired image channels and objective are selected. The fluorescence acquisition time, which is comprised of a series of exposures, is the length of time that the cells are excited. The acquisition time options are set to a default values of 300 milliseconds for green and 400 milliseconds for red fluorescence. We have determined that these default times are the optimal exposures when scanning across a wide variety of fluorescent reporters using the Incucyte. However, should it be necessary, it is possible to modify these values. For example, in the case of fluorescent signal saturation when using bright fluorophores. Next, the user selects the objective. This will be dependent on experimental needs and is selected for each vessel, irrespective of which objectives are in use with other vessels. The Incucyte S3 and S3 for neuroscience has three objectives to choose from on an automated turret: 4x, 10x, and 20x. The vessel selection page lists all the vessel types that the Incucyte system can support. Should a scanning mode other than standard be selected, then only those vessels which are applicable for that scanning mode and objective will be displayed. Users can search for vessels in several ways. For example, by manufacturer, catalog number, or number of wells. In the vessel location page, users can select a position in the Incucyte where their vessel is located. Recommended best practice is to physically load the vessel into the Incucyte gantry before beginning scheduling. For the Incucyte S3 and S3 for neuroscience, all three tray locations are available. Should the selected location already contain a vessel, then a warning message and table appear with the option to remove that vessel from the schedule. The scan pattern page displays a vessel overview, which allows the user to select the location of wells within the vessel to be scanned. When scanning microplates, it's very important to not select wells which do not contain cells, as this can interfere with the Incucyte's autofocusing. Once locations are selected, holding Alt before clicking and dragging will deselect multiple locations. Next, the user can specify the number of images that are to be acquired per well. Generally, it is recommended to acquire 2 images per well for adherent cell types or homogeneously distributed cells, and 4 images per well for suspension cell types, in a 96 well plate with the 10x objective using the standard scanning mode. The estimated scan duration, based on the chosen scan settings, is displayed at the bottom of the page. On the vessel notebook page, details about the vessel can be added, including the vessel name, the cell type, and the passage number. Clear naming is important to allow vessels to be searchable following scanning. It is also important to create or import a plate map for the vessel. This allows the Incucyte to group replica wells when exporting data and acts as an experimental record. Please refer to the How to Create a Plate Map video tutorial to learn how to create a plate map. Notes can also be added to the notebook should they be needed. Once assays and analyses have been run multiple times and are established, it is possible to launch analysis in conjunction with image acquisition. The appropriate analysis type is selected, allowing the selection of the desired analysis definition. Spectral mixing values, having been determined previously, are then inputted along with any notes. If the assay has not been performed previously, then it is recommended to defer the analysis until later and run it post-acquisition. On the scan schedule page, the user specifies a schedule for the vessel. There are 4 options to add scans to a schedule. User scan, create a new schedule with defined scan intervals, for example, every 2 hours, independent of the existing schedule. Add the vessel to an existing schedule should one be present. This will group the new vessel with an existing vessel or vessels, and each will be scanned sequentially at each defined time point. Create a new schedule with advanced scheduling options, which can be opened by right-clicking the timeline and selecting Set Scan Interval. This allows users to define a specific start time, for example 11 a.m., the scan interval, for example every hour, and the window of scanning during each 24-hour interval. In this example, choosing a total of 12 hours means that the vessel will be scanned every hour until 11 p.m. However, it is important to note that the schedule repeats daily. So in this example, scanning will recommence at 11 a.m. the next day for another 12 hours. Leaving the window of scanning for a total of 24 hours will fill the timeline. Individual scans can also be added to the timeline by clicking. The scheduling option is also available in the schedule overview by double-clicking the timeline. A user can also reserve a tray location and defer scanning until later, with vessel scheduling performed in the schedule overview by double-clicking the timeline. Following schedule selection, the duration of the experiment can also be defined. Scan indefinitely will continue scanning until the user manually stops the experiment and is recommended for new experiments. The user can also define a specific endpoint, either a number of days or hours after the experiment commenced, or a specific date and time. Following scheduling, the summary screen displays the selected scheduling options. Here, the user can click on each name to automatically go to that page to make any changes. Once the user is satisfied with the schedule, clicking Add to Schedule adds that vessel to the timeline. The vessel and the schedule are now visible to all users.